I chose to call my channel A Few Minutes with Marvin because this is a channel based on what I believe and on my experiences that I wish to share freely. And not with any hopes, but if it resonates with somebody of like mind, and if I can be of help to somebody through my story, through my vision, through my freedom, and sharing that, it helps somebody else, fantastic. That's what I'm here for. But that's why I didn't call it anything else. The point of this video is to tell you that you can be free, just be uniquely you. You don't have to be anybody else. You don't have to believe what anybody else says. You can listen to other people, but that's their truth. That's their beliefs. So thank you for spending a few minutes with Marvin. Hello, and welcome to another episode of A Few Minutes with Marvin. I inspire those who aspire to make positive changes in their lives. And in this video, I'm going to cover a topic of freedom. And explain to you how truly free I am. And you may think you're already free, but this video may enlighten you onto what freedom really is, and maybe different than what you were expecting. So, but if after watching this video you are a little confused about whether or not you're in freedom, or whether you're an embodiment of freedom. I am a transformational life coach. The link to my website's down below. Give me a shout and let's get together and try to figure out what's blocking you from truly being free today and every day. As you can see by the images that I chose to incorporate in this video, this is embodiment of freedom to me. And I wasn't free. In my past, I was pretty much led by what other people made me believe was freedom. You know, I was taught that to achieve the American dream, you had to work really hard, save your money, have nice things, you know, and be competitive, and be judgmental of others, and you know, and I fell into it, and I'm sure many people are in that as well. And what freedom really is freedom to be who you truly want to be and choose to be, not what somebody else told you to be, not what somebody with a certificate or a diploma or PhD, or somebody who's an anchor on a television set, or a highly paid athlete, or a highly paid movie star, or somebody in a big tech industry, or somebody in the pharmaceutical industry, or somebody even with a medical degree. Because the way I embodied my freedom was to realize that those things that they're pushing on us or want us to believe are their beliefs, and I don't have to believe those. Yeah, you know, and it's not about, you know, calling them liars or, you know, saying that they're indoctrinated by their diplomas or their degrees, or that they've been manipulated, or that they're motivated by money or whatever. Those things don't matter. That's judgment. And I used to judge, absolutely, 100%. I used to compare myself to, you know, my idols and things like that. Well, those people are people too. And what they're doing is what they work towards and what gave them their freedom. Now, whether I see them as being free or not, it's not for me to judge. That's up to them. And if they're being held back or being coerced or manipulated or have an agenda, again, that's on them. You know, I choose not to embody what they're telling me anymore. I used to, and I know a lot of you do too as well. And how did I come to this? It came to a lot of introspection. So I had a realize that freedom doesn't come from anybody outside of me, nobody, or no situation. It comes from within. And the way I found that out is, you know, during this pandemic, we had nothing better to do, but I did not want to do what was being projected out there. I didn't want to wear the mask. I didn't want to not be outside. So I chose to go out in nature. And then the times where I was by myself, I wasn't watching television or movies or DVDs or, you know, I was on some social media because I created this channel, and I was listening to other influencers, but I was just taking them as influencers. And if they resonated with me, I went deeper into that subject and did the research for myself. You know, I wasn't beholden to what just they were saying. And I did that a lot. And I was with myself a lot. And I meditated a lot. And I started practices to take care of my immune system and to take care of my mental health and emotional health, and not to sweep things under the rug anymore. But whenever if I felt angry, if I felt alone, if I felt tired, if I felt weak, if I felt like I was trying to judge somebody, I took those feelings in that moment. I didn't let them, simmer. I just said, stop. Why am I feeling this way? And really worked through those processes myself. And this was even before I became a transformational life coach. And then when I took the training to be a transformational life coach, it just helped me even more to realize who I am, and in fixing me or addressing my inner issues, my blocks, anything from my past that may still be lingering, because those are energies that are holding you back. I chose to integrate them and become one with them, and then I just release them. And that's what you have to do to become free. And yeah, you may have to release some really good friends and some family members, and you may have to quit your job because it doesn't resonate with you anymore. That's not your truth anymore. It's not allowing you to be free and to be who you are, because they're putting rules and regulations on you, and it's turning off the TV because they're telling you to do things. Nobody can tell you what to do. Nobody. If that doesn't resonate with you, even if it's they're projecting it to be for the greater good of everybody, is it? If it truly is and it feels like that to you in your heart, not with your mind, with your heart, God bless you. Go for it. Do exactly what you're being told to do. It's okay. But if you're like me and you have questions about everything, do the research and figure it out for yourself. And then whatever feels right to you, not what somebody else says or wrote about or, as a leader, leaders were leaders. We put those people in those positions, or sometimes in some cases we didn't. But the point is, you have to take control of your own life, and you have to choose to be free and not worry about what other people's judgments are about you or what they think is right. It's what you think is right. That's how you become absolutely, totally free. Because I am free. I am free. And it's not about what's going on in this world. I'm not ignoring it, but I'm not allowing it into my life, because that will take away my freedom, in my opinion. And nothing can take away my freedom anymore. I've taken my freedom back, because the truth is, we've been slaves. Slaves to debt, slaves to systems, slaves to laws, which were created, in my opinion, to serve somebody else, not us, not we the people. That's my opinion. And I'm not afraid to speak my opinion. And you have a different opinion? Fantastic. I love it. I respect it. But I have my own opinions. And I'm free to be who I want any old time. And so are you. So I encourage you to really start questioning your life. And don't question it from an outside perspective of how other people see you or what other people believe. Do it from your heart and what you truly believe. And in that instance, you become free. And no, it's not the easiest thing in the world, because we have a lot of preconceived conditions. We've been, for lack of a better word, brainwashed. And we have to break ourselves from those, from somebody else's belief systems. And if you choose to, if you believe them, then fine. Stay there. That's awesome. But if you don't, It's time to be your unique self and embrace who you are regardless. And again, you may lose some people in your life and they'll fall away, and that's because you're raising your frequency, your energy. And if they don't match with that, it's okay, because now you're going to attract those people who will. And it's amazing. You know, when I made my trek out west, all I found was were people were with like minds. We're not the same, and we don't all believe everything the same, but we understand each other and we respect each other's beliefs. Wow, what a difference, right? Not in a society where you, if you don't, if you're not politically correct, or if you're not, you know, believe what everybody else believes, you're an outcast. No, 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 not at all. That makes you unique. We're all unique, and that makes you free. So be free, my friends. I encourage it. It's breathtaking. It's amazing. Just look at these beautiful images that I've portrayed on here. This is my freedom, and you can have it too. So be an embodiment of freedom, your freedom, and be unique, uniquely you. So you can't be anybody else, and you can't let anybody else influence who you are. Only you truly know who you are. So dig deep, my friends. Listen to your heart and be free. This is what freedom represents to me. I highly encourage it. It's breathtaking. It's beautiful. My life is beautiful. And yours can be too. Have an amazing day. And if you like the contents of this video, please hit the subscribe button, because I'd love to grow a community of like-minded individuals who want to express their freedom and choose to be free and happy and choose to serve others because they've served themselves and they filled their own cup. So now they can fill somebody else's cup just by being and just by choosing to do what they want to do in every now moment. And hit the like button, share this video, and leave a comment. Thank you so much for spending a few minutes with me.